Justin Timberlake, that is Selfish. 17 minutes past 10. Sarah in for Alice this morning. Some surprising rain going on at the moment. Full weather forecast on the way in the next 10 minutes or so. Before that, though, it's the final day of Glastonbury today, which means one thing.
Let's go, girls.
Yes, the iconic Shania Twain performing in the legend slot on the Pyramid Stage later on. You can catch her performance on BBC Two and on iPlayer at 6:15. It comes at a time, right, when country music feels as though it's absolutely everywhere, with artists like Beyoncé, Shaboozy, Dasha taking the charts by storm. So what has caused this resurgence? And what can we expect from Shania's performance today? Well, Ben Atkinson is doing a PhD in women and country music. This is quite the subject, Ben. How did you end up doing this?
Hello. Yes, it is. Well, I've had an interest in that for a very long time. Being from here in the UK, I always sort of listened a lot growing up to the women of country music, and never could quite understand why they had such popularity here in the UK, but not so much in the US, in as much as I mean they're kind of gatekept by the industry very much in America. And Shania is one of those who has been able to break through and make a success of it. But yeah, I wanted to investigate that idea more. And speak to women working in country music, performing in country music today, and get their experience and stories of how their careers have developed, basically.
Before we get stuck into the resurgence then, are you as excited as I am at the prospect of seeing Shania Twain arrive at the Pyramid Stage on horseback?
Yes, yes, of course I am. I grew up listening to this music because, you know, Shania in the late 90s was popular all over the world, everywhere. I remember being at school discos and these songs being played on repeat at those things. It wasn't anything to do with country music. I don't think I even knew that's what it was at that age, you know? But she's a phenomenon, I think.
Yeah, there is something about Shania, isn't it? Because I sort of alluded to those artists who've kind of got back on board the country bus more recently, like Beyoncé and Shaboozy and Dasha. But Shania has pretty much always been at it. And in order to do that, you've got to stay relevant for a long period of time. So what is it that she has managed to do, which has allowed her to stay popular?
I think she's always skirted the line between pop and country, right? And has been in the both of those camps the whole time, rather than doing something like perhaps Taylor Swift has done and jumping directly into the pop camp. She stayed kind of between those two, and they're two really huge genres. So you can sell a lot of records in that space. I mean, Shania has sold over 100 million records. So she's one of the best-selling music artists of all time, but also the biggest-selling female country artist ever. And she's done that largely from just four records. She's done a couple of new ones in the last couple of years, but the main part of her career was just four records. And she took that sort of hiatus from 2002 all the way up till about 2015. So there was a long period where she wasn't actually performing or making new music, but she still remained relevant and popular.
Yeah, and as far as Taylor Swift is concerned, because obviously her roots were originally country, she's moved away from that more recently, but is she still a big player in the country scene in terms of allowing that resurgence to happen?
Shania Twain, she's done some stuff more recently that is new, but I think she would probably now be considered a heritage act because of how far she is along in her career, her age, and all these other things. But certainly what she did in the 90s and what a lot of the women in the 90s did has set the scene for the resurgence that's happening now. Because it was nearly 30 years ago in like 93, 94, of course, when women in country music really became popular for the first time internationally around the world. It was a huge sort of period for them. And that's what we're seeing again now with the artists you mentioned. I mean, most of the artists you just mentioned, they're all women in country music. And that's the big thing about right now.
That's interesting, isn't it? That actually, that's a very good point. Most of the artists that are still remaining current in this field or coming into it are predominantly female. Where are all the men?
Well, they were there for a very long time. They always have been, you know. It's just this particular moment right now. And I think there's also something about the UK to say that in this country, in this market, we kind of are more accepting of those artists, as I said earlier on. You know, in the US, it's always been the case that traditionally the country artist you would think of when you think of country music is a white man in a cowboy hat, right? And women were always, as I said earlier, very gatekept. You know, they wouldn't play women back to back on the radio. They still don't. If you went to a record label as a young woman trying to start a career in country music, you'd be told, I've already got one lady on my label. I don't need another one. You know, most of the number ones that traditionally women have had have been on the back of male artists as duets. And that's still the case now in recent days. There are a few names that step out, you know, like Dolly Parton, Patsy Cline, Tammy Wynette, these people, but there's not a huge number. There are lots of artists, but there's only a small number that really break through. Mm. And I think that's starting to change now.
Where does Taylor Swift fit in all of this?
Well, she's huge, isn't she? Of course, she's really huge now, but that's largely because of this tour that she's doing. You know, she hasn't made her recent, she's a billionaire now. She's the first billionaire pop star, I think, that we've seen. And that's largely off the back of the Eras tour and the merchandising, all of these things, the business side of it, not so much the music alone. I mean, she's huge, but of course, she is able to move between genres quite easily. You know, all of her records tend to sort of be different types of genres, a bit of folk here, a little bit of pop there. And Shania and people like Dolly Parton, they kind of have stayed in their lane in a way. And that's worked really well for them. But yeah, no denying that Taylor is huge at the moment, but it'll be interesting to see where that goes, I think, longevity wise.
Well, it'll be interesting to see where all of it goes, actually, because are there a whole raft of country acts waiting to step into the mainstream? Is this just the beginning of it exploding all over again, do you think?
I think it's really interesting because in the past, and I was thinking about this, in the past, particularly here in the UK, where country music has been popular, it's been the result of one or two people doing the work. You know, we had the Wembley festivals in the 90s, if anybody remembers those, they were really big, but it was largely the work of one person organizing all of that. We now have the Country to Country Festival. It's been going 10 years. And the big difference is there's a lot of buy-in now from business and from, you know, organizations in the genre of country music. So the CMA in Nashville and a lot of the ticketing companies and the venues, they're all buying in together to make this a big thing. And I think that's what's going to be the change. That's what's going to keep it at the level that it's at. You need that buy-in. Of course, these artists are coming over from the US. A lot of the time in the past, they wouldn't actually tour here because they thought they would lose money. And now they're actually making money because they've got, you know, probably got subsidies, I suppose. But also they're hearing that other artists are coming over and it's kind of like a snowball effect. You know, now the UK and Europe more widely is where you want to be if you want to move in a larger direction with your music, I think.
Very interesting. Ben, thank you. That's Ben Atkinson, who's doing a PhD in women and country music. As I mentioned, Shania Twain performing in the Legend slot on the Pyramid stage later on. You can catch her performance on BBC Two and on iPlayer at 6:15. Speaking of which, she's bound to bust this one out, isn't she? Shania Twain, that don't impress me much.